Hello and welcome back to another video. Today in this video, I'll be telling you about 10 amazing superhero gadgets that would blow your mind. You are watching Top Tech Junction and let's continue with this video. Number 1. Iron Man Glove. He might not work at Stark Industries, but that hasn't stopped real-life inventor and YouTuber Patrick Freed from creating a piece of gear that looks like it could have come directly from the popular Iron Man movie franchise. Freed recently created a real-life Iron Man glove. In a video demonstration, the 32-year-old Freed, who is based in Germany, showed how a 3,000-megawatt blue laser embedded in the glove's palm could blow up balloons from across the room, burn wood, and sizzle an orange. Freed says the entire project took him 3 weeks to complete, which is pretty quick considering how complex the thing is. According to Freed, back in the day, I was fascinated by lasers. It all started with the older Battlestar Galactica movies in 2003 or so. I had some time to tinker a bit. Also, just to let you guys know, it's not really called the Iron Man glove, it's the Iron Man Repulsors. Number 2. Pyro Fire Shooter. Illusionist is a company that normally specializes in magic tricks and sleight of hand, but they have a new gadget on the market that breaks the mold for the average magician. The Pyro is a device that allows you to shoot fireballs from your wrist with ease. That's right, this machine gives you the power to shoot fire with a click of a button. So how does it work? You just become a demon from the underworld like Scorpion or Ghost Rider. Oh, just kidding. The pyro comes with two barrels that are filled with a special tissue paper used in many magical pyrotechnics that burns really fast. When the paper launches out of its lit barrels, it burns so quickly that all the naked eye really catches is the fireball, as the company notes. This is a doodad that shoots actual fire and therefore it is very potentially dangerous when not used in the appropriate manner. Of course, the pyro should be handled with extreme caution, but whether you are an aspiring magician or simply want a cool new party trick, the pyro was an essential addition to your arsenal. Number 3. Hoverbike Scorpion 3. For anyone who has dreamed of taking to the skies in a hovercraft, a Russian tech company has recently made that dream a very real possibility. The Hoverbike Scorpion 3 is an extreme sports machine for those who are not afraid of height and speed. Layout of Scorpion 3 is like an ordinary motorcycle, but it can fly. As you might expect, the carbon fiber vehicle doesn't come cheap. For those wanting to purchase one of their very own, your $10,000 deposit will be followed up with a $150,000 price tag. The plan to classify the hoverbike as an ultra-light vehicle resulted in some minor design tweaks to fulfill the legal requirements of the classification, but this final commercial iteration is still at its core the same crazy quadcopter hoverbike. The Scorpion 3 features similar physical drone designs. Essentially, it is a larger than usual drone capable of lifting actual people instead of small packages. It has four arms with powerful rotors at each end. It runs out of battery that requires recharging before each flight. Controls are on board, consisting of two joysticks for basic directional management. The sub 250-pound craft is designed to skim over the landscape at the company's specified safe altitude of about 16 feet and at speeds of up to 60 miles an hour. It's a pretty cool thing, not gonna lie. It's pretty aesthetic as well. It looks like a heavy bike, not gonna lie. And I think it has a great aesthetic going on. Number 4. Kitty Hawk. The Green Goblin is a popular character from the Spider-Man universe who was famously played by Willem Dafoe in the early 2000s. He has a very distinctive form of transport, namely a flying platform that soars through the sky. Think about it, hero! Though it isn't identical tech, startup Kitty Hawk recently launched a vehicle that will surely advance the world of flying transport. The company, led by former Google self-driving car visionary Sebastian Thrown, has now flown its first aircraft. The one-person flyer more than 25,000 times, but tiny Kitty Hawk flyer seats just one person in a central pod flying by 10 propellers powered by batteries. It can fly up to 10 feet off the ground at speeds of up to 20 miles per hour. Battery life is set to be 12 to 20 minutes, depending on speed and pilot weight. In the US, the flyer falls under the FAA rules for ultraviolet aircraft, meaning no pilot's license is needed as long as it's flown over water or uncongested areas. It's the kind of vehicle that anyone can learn to fly in 15 minutes, and employee says the computer does all the hard work, so the human is just left to do things that people are really good at. Look out at the window, decide where you want to go, and just point the stick to where you want it to go and land. Number 5. Jetpack Suit. Richard Browning is a British inventor who has always dreamed of flying, so when he saw Tony Stark's levitating jetpack suit and the Iron Man movies, he decided to try his hand at designing one. This incredible invention was built by Browning using 3D printed parts specialist electronics and 5 jet engines. Once you've strapped it on and mastered the basics, you can soar at speeds of 32 miles per hour and ascend to altitudes of 12,000 feet. The only heat you feel is just standing there in a leather jacket on a warm summer's day. The heat is strangely, well, blown away. It's actually surprisingly calm and not very violent. It's very passive and gentle. To set a world record in the suit, he achieved the fastest speed in a body control jet engine powered suit at 85.6 miles per hour. Number 6. Bulletproof suit. This suit can be just like the Immortal Hulk and dodge bullets like they're nothing with this beautifully tailored, totally classy bulletproof suit. Forget the Hulk, this is more like a Superman thing. Hulk can also smash stuff, you know. The Garrison bespoke bulletproof suit is made from the same carbon nanotubes used for troop uniforms in Iraq. The suit was originally conceived by Toronto tailor Garrison Bespoke, who kept getting requests from clients who work in the Diamond List, which is a diamond industry, for a bulletproof work suit to protect themselves from armed robberies. Suit will set you back about $20,000, but that's a small price to pay for saving your life, wouldn't you say so? If you've got a dangerous job, or the president working a jewelry store, or simply you want to be an immortal version of James Bond, the suit will take you from average Joe to indestructible Joe. Number 7. Kuratas. Kuratas is a ride table and user-operated mecha built by the Japanese company's Suitobashi Heavy Industry Build. It is the world's first giant boarding robot. The Kuratas was unveiled when the website was opened in 2012. The vehicle weighs approximately 4,500 kilograms and is approximately 4 meters high. It can be crewed by one person. That operator would sit in the body of the robot in a seat with a control device in front of them. The Kuratas can also be controlled externally by remote control, can sport a 4-wheeled 30-joint exoskeleton which is controlled by the pilot or can be controlled remotely. Number 8. Mayo Armband. This device is pretty cool. It's basically an armband that makes you feel like a god. Remember that scene in Bruce Almighty where he makes a fire hydrant explode with a single gesture? That's basically what the Mayo Armband is, except you control technology and the signals. The Mayo to work like a wireless remote on all your devices. Bend your wrist forward to fast forward through a video, bend it back to rewind. You can also hook up the Mayo armband to your drone and control it with your hand gestures alone. It's as simple as downloading the Mayo app on your wireless device, and before you know it, you're scrolling through Spotify with a flick of a wrist. Number 9. Bionic Ants. Anyone familiar with the Marvel Cinematic Universe knows that Paul Rudd's character Ant-Man is able to communicate with his namesake insect ants. But it turns out this ant army is not as fantastical as it seems. Tech company Festo is bio-inspired bionic ants robots which replicate the form of function of workers. Ants are the company's latest entries into the Industry 4.0 movement and robotic revolution. They embody the main themes of swarm artificial intelligence acting autonomously while communicating and collaborating with the other ants to devise a strategy to reach a final goal. Like the Industry, as insects, bionic ants can find and move objects that are bigger than their own bodies. Real ants do this by adhering to a strict caste system and communicating via pheromones, sound, and touch. Number 10. Lilium Electric Flying Vehicle. Another entry into the world of flying cars is Lilium Electric Flying Vehicle. In a video provided by the Munich-based company Williams Unpiloted, aircrafts can be seen taking off vertically like a helicopter, hovering briefly and then landing. It may not seem like much, but it's a big step for the company, which hopes to launch a fully operational flying taxi service in multiple cities by 2025. Bill Lilium says the gleaming 5-seat electric car can fly 186 miles an hour. Its first flight, like most such tests, were modest. The Lilium jet certainly stands out. It has an egg-shaped cabin perched on landing gear with a pair of parallel tilt rotor wings. The wings are fitted with a total of 36 electric jet engines but tilt up for vertical takeoff and then shift forward for horizontal flight. The company says there have been hundreds of tests already that have happened since then. Gerber said in an interview, it already started becoming a bit like normality to see it fly. But we are super excited to show that to the world. It plans to eventually release a consumer-facing app that lets users hail the jet like they would a taxi on Uber. As far as how much the rise will cost, the firm has said it plans to take New Yorkers from Manhattan to JFK Airport within 6 minutes for about $70. This is all for today, folks. If you enjoyed this video, then leave a like, and if you are new, then subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.